Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video we will discuss about what is map interface and its implementation classes. And in this video we will cover map interface, its implementation class, hash map, linked hash map, identity hash map, weak hash map, and we'll also cover its interface, sorted map, navigable map, and tree map, and hash table and properties class. This we will cover in this video. So okay, let's start with its root interface, that is map. Map is not the child interface of collection interface. If you want to represent a group of objects as key value pair, then we should go for map. And here both the key and values are object, and duplicate keys are not allowed in map, but value can be duplicate. And here we have created one map object, and here we can see the key is 1 and value is Karan, and in the second object key 2, value Rohit. Like this we have added 3 object in map object. Now when we should go for collection and when we should go for map interface. If we want to represent group of individual objects, then we should go for collection. If we want to represent group of object as key value pair, then we should go for map interface, because map store the object in the form of key value pairs, and each object here is one entry. And these are the methods of map interface. First one is object put, and this method is used to add the key value pair to the map. If the specified key is already available, then old value will be replaced with the new value. And the next one is put all, that is used to add a group of key value pairs. And the third one is object get. If we want to get any object based on its key, then we can use this function. And the next one is remove, that is used to remove the object. And next one is used to check contains key. If map object this key, then it will return true, otherwise false. Like this same function contains value. If we want to check the map object contains this value, then here we will pass the value. If it contains that value, then it will return true, otherwise it will return false. And the next one is int size, that is used to check the size of map object. And boolean is empty. If the map is empty, then it will return true, otherwise false. And this function is used to clear the map object. And the next one is keySet function, that is used to get the all keys value from our map object. And values function is used to get all the values from our map object. And the next one is entrySet, that is used to get all entry in the form of set. Now we will use these all functions in one program. Okay, let's start to create one program. So here I will open Eclipse. But before creating this program, first we need to discuss about its implementation class, that is HashMap. Then we will use the HashMap as an implementation class while creating map object. So here now we will discuss about HashMap. What is HashMap? The underlying data structure used in HashMap is hash table. And heterogeneous objects are allowed for both the keys and values. And duplicate keys are not allowed in HashMap, but values can be duplicate. And insertion order is also not preserved, because in HashMap we use hash code value of the keys to store the objects. And null is also allowed, but only once. And null values are allowed any number of times. And these are the points to be noted. And these are the constructors of HashMap. First one is HashMap m is equal to new HashMap. And it creates an empty HashMap object with default initial capacity level is 16. And its default fill ratio will be 0.75. And the second one is HashMap map is equal to new HashMap int initial capacity. So here we can provide our own manual initial capacity to the map object. And third one is If we want to define our own initial capacity, and we also want to define our custom fill ratio, then we can use this constructor. And the next one is hash map. Map is equal to new hash map. This is used to convert any map object into hash map. Now we will create one program and will use these functions in our hash map. So here I will create one map object by using new hash map implementation class of map interface. So here the key value will be like string comma string. So key is string and value also string. So here I will put the object by using put function, map put here we will add its first name, that is Karan, and last name here, that is Reddy. Like this we will add multiple objects. So here I have added three names. Now just I will run this application and we'll see the output run as Java application, and here we can see the output on the console: Karan Reddy, Venkatesh Reddy and Vivek Reddy. If I will try to add one more object with the same key like this, if I am using this object and here I am using the same key but with some different value, then what will here, then this key, this object will be updated. Now I will run this again. So first here I will print this. Now here we will see the output. First one was Karan Reddy, Venkatesh Reddy, Vivek Reddy, but after updating the object, Karan Reddy, Venkatesh Reddy and Vivek Sharma. This is the output. Because if we are using the same key adding again, then it will update and override the previous object. And if we want to get all the key sets, then we can use the function that is key set. If we want to just get the first one keys, Karan, Vivek and Venkatesh, these three want to get, then we can use key set function of map, map dot key set. So here what it will return, it will return the set of keys. So now I will just print this, that is key set. And here we can see all keys in the one group. If I want to get all values like this, Reddy, Reddy and Sharma, then I can use the function that is map.values. It will return all the values from our map object. So here it will assign the statement. Now I just print the values. Now here we can see all values in a one group. So if we want to just get the keys, then we can use key set function. If we want only values, then we can use values function. Like this we can use other functions also, contains value, contains key. So here if I will use contains key function, map dot contains key, here I will pass one key, that is Karan. If it is available, then it will return true, otherwise false. So Karan key is available, so it's returning the true. But if I will put some other name, that is Rohit, and this is not available, so what will be the output here? It will return false because this key is not available. Like this we can use its other functions also. And the next one that we will discuss is linked hash map. Linked hash map is the child class of hash map and it is exactly same as hash map, but there are few differences between both. And these are the differences between both hash map and linked hash map. Hash map internally used hash table data structure, whereas linked hash map internally using hash table and linked list. So insertion order is preserved in linked hash map, but in hash map insertion order is not preserved because their object will be inserted based on its hash code value of the key. And the next one is identity hash map. Identity hash map internally uses the equal to operator to identify the duplicate keys. And identity hash map, it is exactly same as hash map except the following difference. In the case of hash map, to identify the duplicate keys, JVM always uses dot equals method, which is mostly meant for content comparison. But if we want to use equal to operator instead of dict equals method to identify the duplicate keys, then we should go for identity hash map. Now we will create one program and we'll see the difference between hash map and identity hash map. So here I have created one hash map object and here I have created two objects for integer and have the same value 10 and 10, and object is i1 and i2. Now I am going to add both objects into map. So here I have using put method, i1 Karan and i2 is Rohit. So now I will run this application. Then HashMap will check the duplicate keys based on its dot equals method will be used internally. So it will check if the content is same, then it will override the previous object. So now I will run this application, run as Java application. So here the output is 10 and Rohit, because when I have added the same object with the same key, I have added different object but the key was same, then it was overridden. And as we know, identity hash map internally uses dot equal to operator, and dot equal to operator meant for reference comparison. So here if I will use identity hash map, then what will be the output? Now we can see both object will be printed because i1 is referencing to the different object and i2 is referencing to the different object. And here we can see i1 is referencing to different object and i2 is referencing to the different object. And equal to operator meant for reference comparison. So here both keys will be added. Now I will run this application and here we can see the output 10 Karan, 10 Rohit. When we was using hash map to check the identity of key, then it was returning the true because equals method meant for content comparison. But when we are using identity hash map, this was internally using equal to operator, and that is meant for reference comparison. And these both objects are referencing to the different objects. So here it's returning false and we can see the output here. And the next one is weak hash map. And weak hash map, it is exactly same as hash map except the following differences. In the case of hash map, object is not eligible for garbage collector even though it does not have any external reference. If it is associated with hash map, then it will not able to destroy. But in the case of weak hash map, even though object is associated with weak hash map, but it will be eligible for garbage collector if it does not have any external reference. So let's create one program and we will see the difference there. So here we can see the difference between hash map and weak hash map. Here we are using hash map and here I have created one object for hash map, and here I have added one object that is map.put and integer i1 here I have added, and value is the current. Then I will print this map, and after printing this object I have make this i1 is equal to null. So here we can see I even have no reference. But now I will call system.garbage collector, but this object will not be eligible for garbage collection. And again I will print this value. Then here we can see the output will be printed again. Same output will be printed two times. So now I will run this application. And here we can see the output. Now thread is sleeping for 5 seconds. Now after 5 seconds again the object is printed with same value. But if we are using here weak hash map, if I am using here weak hash map, then what will be happen here? Now same integer I have created and same object I have added into map. Now I have make this object as null, means this object has no reference. So when I will call garbage collector, the garbage collector will destroy this object, that is map object. So again I will run this application and here we will see the output. Now this time only one single time the object will be printed, and after 5 seconds the empty object will be printed, because this time the object is eligible for garbage collection. Because weak hash map object will be eligible for garbage collector if it does not have any external references or contain null value. And now the next one is sorted map interface. And if we want to represent a group of object as key value pairs according to some sorting order, then we should go for sorted map. And sorting should be done based on keys, but not based on object values. And these are the methods of sorted map, that is object first key. If we want to get the key of first object, then we can use this object last key. If we want to get the last key from the map object, then we can use this function. And like this we can use head map, that will return the head object of the key. And like this tail map and sub map. The same function we have discussed in sorted set, like same functionality they will perform here. And the next one is navisable map. Navisable map, it is the child interface of sorted map to define the several methods for navigation purpose. And these are the methods of navisable map. Ceiling key, that will return the lowest element from this element. And the next one is higher key. So this function will return the lowest element from this element. And floor key is also return the highest element from the element. And the next one is poll first entry. It will use to remove and return the first element. And poll last entry is used to return and remove the last entry from the map object. And descending map is used to return the navisable set in reverse order. It will return the map in reverse order. Now we will create one program and will use these all functions. So here I will create one tree set object, that is the implementation class for navisable map. So here it will be tree map. So here I have created the object for tree map, that is the implementation class used for navisable map. And here I have added 5 object B, A, C, E, D. It is not in ascending order, but when I will print this object, here the output will be in ascending order. So now I will run this application. So here we can see the output in ascending order, first A, then B, then C, D and E. Now I will use these all functions. Now here I have declared all the functions of navisable map, that is ceiling key, higher key, floor key, lower key, poll first entry, poll last entry and descending map. Now I will run this. So here we will see the output. Run as Java application. And here we can see the output. when we have used tm.cling key have entered the value c, then its output was c, and next the higher key was null because there is no element that is greater than e, so here its output is null. So here if I will use d, then we will check it again, and here we will use the same run as Java application. Now output will be c, and here we can see the ceiling key is c and the higher key is e, because from d the higher key is e, and the next one is floor key, that is d, so its lower key and equal to key is d, and the lower key from d is c, and the tm dot poll first entry have removed the first from the map object, so this one has removed, that is a is equal to apple when we called this function, and when we called last entry poll last entry, then this element also removed. So in the last when we printed the output, so here we can see the map have only three values b, c and d, first entry and last entry removed by these both functions, and descending map is used to reverse the map objects. So here we have used all the functions of navisable map, and now the next one is tree map. In the tree map, the underlying data structure is red black tree, and the insertion order is not preserved in tree map, and all the entries will be inserted according to some sorting order of keys that will be ascending or descending. So if we are depending on default natural sorting order, the keys should be homogeneous and comparable, means should be same type of the object and should be comparable interface implemented by this class, otherwise we will get exception. And if we are defining our own sorting order by comparator, then the keys need not be homogeneous and comparable, because there are no restriction on values, they can be heterogeneous and non-comparable, and duplicate keys are not allowed, but values can be duplicated. And here if we will see the null acceptance for the entry for the empty tree map, as the first entry with null key is allowed, but after inserting that entry, if we are trying to insert any other object, then we will get null pointer exception. If our tree already contain few objects and we are going to add null value as a object, then it will throw null pointer exception. And in the values we can add any number of null values, there are no restriction on values, we can insert null in value but not in keys. And these are the constructors of tree map. Tree map t is equal to new tree map, that is zero parameterized tree map, and the default natural sorting order will be provided by this constructor. If we are using tree map t is equal to new tree map and comparator c, then we can provide our own customized sorting order. And third one is tree map map. If we want to convert any map object into tree map, then we can use this constructor. And fourth one is sorted map. If we want to convert sorted map into ascending or descending order, then we can use this constructor. Now we will create two programs, one for this constructor and second for this constructor, that is used to provide customized sorting order, and first one is used to provide default natural sorting order. Okay, let's go to Eclipse and clean this. Here we have created tree map object and added three values. Now I will run this one so we can see the object will be in the sorting order, that is A will be the first and B second, 3 V C will be the third place, so it provides sorting order. And the next we will check the null acceptance. If I try to add tm dot put, and here I will set the null value as a key, then it will throw null pointer exception. If I will use this one and I will run this, now this will throw the null pointer exception. So here we can see java.lang null pointer exception. Because null is not inserted into tree map, if key is not acceptable as a null value, but if I will use value as a null, then it is acceptable. If I will run this, now we can see it is acceptable. Value as null acceptable, but key as null not acceptable. It will throw null pointer exception. And in tree map we can add only heterogeneous object, homogeneous object. If I will try to add heterogeneous, means here we are adding string object. If I will try to add integer, so here it will throw compile time error. And if I will remove this one from here, and this is also from here, and now it will not show compile time error, but runtime it will throw exception. That is class cast exception, because java.lang string cannot be cast to java.lang integer, because it is accepting only string. And as we know, tree map is not supported to the heterogeneous object, it supports just homogeneous object. Means we can insert only same type of object. If here is string, then it should be string and every key should be string, but here we are inserting 10, that is integer, so it's throwing class cast exception, because here it is also expecting the string value. So if I will change it here from integer to string, then it will not throw any exception. Now here we can see the object that we have used as a string as a key, it was homogeneous and comparable. Comparable means string class implemented comparable interface, and it providing default natural sorting order. And if we want to provide our own customized sorting order, then what we should do, then we need to use second constructor, that is tree map comparator C. This constructor when we need to use if we want to provide own customized sorting order. So now what we will do, here we will use comparator. Now here I will create one class, that is my comparator, and we can give any name that will implements comparator interface. Comparator interface that is used to provide our own customized sorting order. So here what we need to do, add unimplemented methods. So here we need to override compare method. So what we will do here, here it will convert object 1 into true string, because it will convert just only key of the object. So here it will string s1, and next we need to convert o2 is also into string. And here it will be O2 and S2, and here we need to return, and return function will return the response by using S2.compare function. Here we will call, and compare to function will be used to compare the two objects. So here I will pass S1, and now what we need to do, here we need to pass this object as a parameter of this constructor. Now I will run this, and here we can provide our own customized sorting order. Run as Java application, and here we can see E was the first order and C in the second. B means it was descending order, and here we have used comparator to provide the customized sorting order. And in customized sorting order, what we did here, we just reverse the original map object. And now the next one is hash table. The underlying data structure is hash table, and the heterogeneous objects are allowed for both keys and values. And insertion order is not preserved. And order will be decided based on the hash code of the keys. And null is not allowed for both keys and value. If we will try to add null in keys or value anywhere, then it will throw null pointer exception. And duplicate keys are not allowed but values can be duplicated. And all the methods inside Hashtable are synchronized, so it is thread safe. And these are the constructors of Hashtable. First one is zero parameterized, and the default size of is 11. So we can use an empty Hashtable with this default constructor, and initial capacity of Hashtable will be 11, and the default fill ratio will be 75%. And the second constructor is used to provide initial capacity by user, and the third one is used to provide initial capacity with fill ratio of Hashtable object, and the fourth one is used to convert any map object into Hashtable. So let's go to Eclipse, and here we will create one program by using Hashtable. So first we will remove this one, and here we will create one Hashtable object. And here I have added four objects. Now I will run this one, run as Java application, and here we can see the output. There is no ascending order, that is default order decided by hashcode key value. So first is B apple, A apple, D apple, then C. The order was decided based on the hashcode of the key. So this was the order. It was not ascending or descending order, or not a customized order. And if we will try to add null as a value in Hashtable, then it will throw null pointer exception. So here if I will try to add null as a value, then it will throw exception, that is null pointer exception. So null is not possible in value or as a key. It will throw always null pointer exception if you will try to add null. And the next one is properties. Property is the child class of Hashtable, and in case of properties, both the keys and values should be string. And in our program, if anything which is changes frequently, like database username, database password, and URL, so never recommended to hard code these values in the Java program. For this we must need to use properties file, because for every change we have to recompile, rebuild, redeploy the application, and these are time consuming process. And if we are doing changes in just properties file, then we just need to redeploy, no need to rebuild, recompile, or just redeploy and run the application. So the main advantage of this approach is, if any change in the properties file, then just redeployment is enough, which is not a business impact to the client. And this is the constructors for properties. Property P is equal to new properties. And in case of properties, both the keys and values should be string type. And these are the methods of properties. First one is get property. Here we will just pass the key of the property, and it will return the value for this specific key. And the second one is set property to set a new property. And third one is enumeration property names, that will be used to return property names. And fourth one is void load, and this will be used to load the properties file from properties into Java properties object. And the last one is store, that is used to update properties from properties object into properties file. Okay, let's create one program and we'll use this function. Okay, let's go to Eclipse, and here we will remove this one. And here I have created one properties file in source packet, that is user.properties. And here I have defined three values. One is equal to Karan, two is equal to Rohit, and three is equal to Mohit. Now I will go to my test class, and here what I did, here I have created object for properties class, and here I am using file input stream to load the file. So this is the path of my user.properties file. that I have defined here. And the next one is used to load the file. It will load all the properties from our property file. Then I have printed all the properties value. And next thing, here I am using get property function to get the value for this key. What will be the name for this key? Then it will print here. So now I will run this application, run as Java application. That is the all the properties from user.property file. And when I call this function p.getProperty and pass the key as 1, then it is print the name for this key, that is Karan. And that was about properties file. And now we have completed each and everything. Okay, now all topics we have covered inside map interface. Thanks for watching this video.